Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. I'm Connie, and behind the camera is my husband, Lonnie. Normally, Lonnie's the one in front of the camera, showing you some bushcraft skills and things, but today we're going to do another Connie's Camp Cooking. Today was such a nice day that we just couldn't resist, and we just wanted to get outside and cook a meal this evening. And we always tend to push the season. There is still some snow patches on the trails as we hiked in, but it's just so nice to be out here. So let me show you what we're going to cook tonight on the fire. We're planning on putting an onion in some foil, and we're going to cook that in the coals, and we'll show you how we're going to do all this stuff each time. And then we're going to cook some moose backstrap steak on the grill over the fire. And then we're going to make some fry bread that's made from sweet potatoes, and we'll fry that in a skillet. And then hopefully we'll do a dessert of peach cobbler. So let's get started on all this. Okay, this is how we do the onion. You just make wedges in it and then put butter in between each wedge, and then we put a beef bouillon cube down in the center, and as the juices all cook and it dissolves that beef bouillon into the juices, and it's so yummy. We have done this before, but it's been a long time ago. And this is such a big onion, we're going to put two bouillon cubes and hope that we didn't do too much. And then Lonnie's going to wrap this up for me so that he can make a really good, nice seal to bury it in the coals in the fire. One thing I do want to mention about the foil is you want to be sure and use heavy-duty aluminum foil, because I think that holds up better in the fire.
Okay, this is going to be a quick video clip, and then I'm going to insert here to show how to properly wrap something to for putting in a fire. Okay, what you want to do is you want to seal this foil. So you want to make it large enough that it will overlap. Okay, bring the two ends together, fold them over like that. And then proceed to roll that up. Just keep rolling it up until it's tight against the item, like that. Okay, now you want to flatten the sides and roll them up the same way. Okay, just like that. Now, once you get this done, you're not done. Okay, now that's the way you do it. Now what you want to do is repeat it. Put it in another piece of foil, wrap it up the same way. That way, it is totally sealed where the juices are not going to leak out. And with two layers of heavy-duty aluminum foil, chances are the foil won't be punctured and you'll lose the juices, which would defeat your purpose of baking in foil in the fire.
Okay, now that we've got the onion cooking in the coals on the fire, now we're going to start in on this bread. And I found this recipe from a site, that YouTube channel that I watch once in a while, called Off Grid with Doug and Stacy. So what you do is you cook up some sweet potato, and then you mash it all up, And so it's equal parts sweet potato and flour. So I have 1 cup of sweet potato in here, and I have 1 cup of flour in this bag. So I'll go ahead and just dump all that in. And then also there's about a half a teaspoon of salt in there. So you just mix this until it gets into a nice stiff dough that you can work with your hands. And I brought extra flour along to dust my hands with and to dust the cutting board with. And so when I get the patties of the sweet potato bread all done on the cutting board, then we'll come back with you. I think Doug and Stacy's video was called The Oldest Bread in the World or something like that. I don't know if it's the oldest bread in the world, but I thought it was pretty tasty. So, I'm going to get this all mixed up, and at home you can use a rolling pin to roll them out, but I'm just going to try and do it with my hands out here. We're going to cook the sweet potato bread in coconut oil. I suppose you could use butter too. So, looks like my skillet's going to be a little uneven, but I'll just have to keep picking it up and running the oil all around. Let me show you the patties that I got done. Ah, that smoke. Okay, these patties are a little bit thicker than what I would do if I were at home. I'd roll them out thinner, make smaller ones and roll them out thinner. But, wow. They're huge. It's only going to get two in the skillet at once. So as you can see, we've got the steaks on now. The onions and the coals underneath. And I've already flipped the first batch of these sweet potato bread. They're looking great. We've made this sweet potato bread at home two or three times, and we really like it. I like it with just to butter them after they come off. And very yummy. Oh yeah, those are ready to come off. So then we'll get the other two going. Our bread is all done. We'll take it off. That's a lot of bread. We probably won't eat all 4 pieces. We'll take some home and have it for tomorrow. Looks like the meat is just about done. Get ready to take that off.
Okay, this is Lonnie here, and Connie is dishing up the onion. Now, we left that in the coals. You saw where we had it, and we had it nestled down in the coals, and then quite a few coals on top of it. And it was in there for 53 minutes. Now, keep in mind, this was a very large onion, so turned out just about perfect.
Okay, we got our plates all dished up with our dinner. We got our sweet potato bread, our moose backstrap steaks, and our onion that we cooked in the coals. So now Lonnie and I are gonna enjoy our dinner while it's still warm, and then we'll come back and work on our dessert. We were just gonna eat our meal and then go on to the dessert, but I took one bite of this onion, and it is so good, it's to die for. I know I'm starving, but this is really good. You've gotta try it. Heavenly. Mmm. Okay, we're getting ready to make our peach cobbler now. And so I've pre-done some of the steps at home. Same with those, the bread that we did. You know, of course I cooked the sweet potato at home and mashed it up and brought it that way, but you can do it all outside. You don't have to do any of this out, you know, pre-stuff at home. But anyway, this is just a basic peach cobbler. I can't remember all the recipe exactly, and so we'll have the recipe in the video description. But this is all the dry ingredients. And then we just need to add a half a cup of milk, which I brought. I halved the recipe that we had at home because I just didn't know how big this, how much I needed for this pan. Looks like it should be just about right. I know that there's flour, sugar, cinnamon, baking powder, but I don't want to start trying to guess at the measurements without knowing for sure. So you can look in the video description for the recipe. So we've got our butter melted in the pan already. We're going to pour this in. This table's kind of slanted. I think this is mixed good enough. Trying to get it to where it's not all going to run to one spot. Let's see. I think it's just going to run to one spot until I can. It'll even out. Okay, and then I already cut up some peaches. Put on top. Try to distribute them kind of evenly around. Lonnie's got the little oven preheating over there. So this will top off our dinner. Speaking of our dinner, oh, you guys, it was so wonderful. Take a bite of that onion with a bite of that steak. And even the bread tasted so much better. I told Lonnie, I said, I think this tastes better than what we've done at home. Maybe it's because smoke flavor of cooking it over a campfire. I don't know. I think that's probably about enough. Don't want to overdo it. Okay, let's get this on the fire. Get it to baking. Okay, we're going to show you the setup that we are cooking our peach cobbler in. The bottom is a firebox wood stove that you just fill it with twigs. And the top is called a zebra pot. So Lonnie's going to check and see. The cobbler should be just about done.
It's a 16 millimeter.
It's a 16 millimeter.
Zebra pot.
Zebra pot. Okay. So, oh, it's looking good. Those are rocks in the bottom that heat up. That you have. Ah, looks so yummy.
Call it good?
Yes, we're going to call that good.
All right.
Okay, we're going to dish some up. Oh yeah, it looks done. We're not sure what this black stuff is. What we think it is smoke, because it did bubble over a little bit in there and the butter kind of went in the bottom and burnt a little bit. So that's what the black is, I think. It'll just add a little campfire flavor to it. Okay. Let me try a little bite real quick, see what it's like. I get a peach in there. Mmm. Mmm. Very good and yummy. It's just something special about being able to bake something when you're out in the woods. Well, thank you so much for coming along with us on this evening and cooking video. So we're going to sign off for now, and we're just thank you for joining us, and you all have a good week, and we'll see you on the next video. You all take care.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.